cheap door.
Bad guy, bad man. You know, ever since when you walked under that ladder, I think your luck has gone bad, don't you? Wouldn't you agree?
Chico, look who's holding all the gold.
Hey, you may be holding it now, but what I meant to say was, I think you're afraid that your luck is going to go bad. If not, then why would you not accept the challenges that you've been offered by Shawn Michaels week after week to put that title, all the gold, on the line against Diesel? Are you afraid you're going to have some bad luck? Is that it, bad guy?
Everybody, listen to me. Hey, Chubby, I think by now the people know Razor likes nothing better than a good fight. You tell the boy toy and Big Daddy Cool they want some of this gold, they got it.
Whoa. Hey, so you're saying, as I...
Anytime.
Okay, okay. I think we all heard it. Anytime, you...
Anybody.
Anybody, anytime. What about any place?
Any place.
Okay, that's what I wanted to hear you say, bad guy. Because Diesel is obviously somebody. And, this is obviously some place, so you're saying that you will defend your title against Diesel right here? Is that what you're saying? He said it. You gonna back down?
Is that what you want, Chico?
I would love to see that, bad guy.
You got it.
You know, it's easy to see why Lord Regal has had such a hard time finding suitable opponents. I mean, after all, it is hard to assess viable competitors when you got your nose firmly planted in the sky, scrambling for eloquent ways to insult the people of America, the people that welcomed you here with open arms, gave you an opportunity to work and enjoy a standard of living second to none on the planet, a privilege that so many Americans have paid a severe price for over the years. And if that isn't enough, he's got that mumbling, bumbling, incoherent nincompoop at ringside. Well, let me tell you something, Sir Regal. Your education is about to come full circle, because when you step inside the ring with Flying Brian, you're going to get a crash course.
Oh, how proud your mother must be. Tonight she'll be sat in that little trailer watching that black and white 14-inch television screen. Oh, her little son's got his chance to wrestle for the title. Think again, Mrs. Pillman. You'll be weeping like Niagara Falls. I am going to expose your son for the blatant, useless piece of nothing that he really is.
We'll be right back.
No wonder Pillman thinks that he has a shot. He lives in a land full of fools run by idiots. I mean, look what you stupid American people have done now. The Brady Bill. Oh yes, all the criminals are going to wait 5 days so they can get their guns. They'll just go and buy them on the black market. What a joke. And then you steal an idea from England, the worst one the government over there ever had, to bring in a health plan. I mean, it's for the paupers. If the poor people haven't got health care, then either get jobs, or it's tough luck on them. It's part of being poor. Do you know what? Do you understand what I'm saying, Mr. Zabisco?
Well, let me ask you something, seeing you're worried about the health care. Are you afraid of Flying Brian?
Am I afraid? What? How have you got the audacity to stand there and say such a ridiculous thing? Who are you, nothing but a microphone holder, to stand there and say such a thing to me?
Well, if you're so great, why did you have to pile drive the guy on a cement?
What? I don't have to do such things. You just hold it.
Saul Duggan doesn't have a lot of respect for anybody but America.
Now is the time, Sam Paul, stand proud for the United States of America. You Englishmen, the Hacksaw Jim Duggan has to get off my deathbed. If I have to get off my deathbed, I will defend our flag. Hey! And we'll send them Englishmen back to that tiny island.
Hey! That sounds like a challenge.
Yeah, think about the history of Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Thank you. As our guests join us at this time, Razor Ramon, the Intercontinental Champion, Diesel, the Challenger. And Diesel, I see you working that right hand there. You know that this one could be in the ring, out of the ring. I asked you this last week. Will you do whatever it takes to win this title?
Undoubtedly, JR. Tonight, I see championship there, Razor. What do you got, big boy? What are you made of, huh? Ooh, are you getting ready? I am. Let me tell you something. I'm going to beat you into a pulp. I'm gonna see what you're made of. I'm gonna test you inside. Yeah. And when it's all said and done, what? Ramon, I'm walking away with the belt.
Yeah, I got news for you, big man. Chico, you wanna be somebody, man?
What a place big to man, win the belt.
You want this? You wanna fight Chico?
Yeah,
hey,
I want one.
No problema, man. We're going to fight because there's nothing they like better than a good fight. And the bad guy, he gonna...
Tonight, 8 o'clock.
Can you dig it, sucker?
Thank you. It's a flair for the gold. It's Fifi. We're live. And today, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, one of the real greats in our sport. Whether you like him or you don't like him, I got to tell you, the guy has got all the genetics. He's got all the gifts. And he came this close to being champion one more time. Ladies and gentlemen, a man on the verge of a world championship, Ravishing Richard Rude. Hey, Rick, how are you, man?
Good, real good.
Hey, have a seat, come on. A flair for the goal, man.
I love it.
You're looking great. Hey, I gotta tell you, I was there, the whole world was there, one of the greatest matches I've ever seen. I'm talking about, you know, you came this hey, over here. Over here. She's like, hey, she'll be there later. We're talking wrestling now. Okay, hey. Like I said, one of the greatest contests I've ever seen.
Yeah, you had a great match too, Rick. Congratulations, okay?
Hey, we're talking time. We're talking about the match in the very near future. We're talking about the rematch.
Wait a minute. You're talking about the rematch. I've got different things on my mind, Flair.
Rick, relax. Relax.
Yeah.
Over here.
You know what I'm thinking about, don't you, Fifi? Don't stand there looking stupid. Come over here.
Hey.
I gave you my phone number. I expect you to call me. Obviously, you don't know what the deal is. Hey, I'm Ravishing Rick Rude, and whatever I want, I get. And as far as the women goes, that's automatic. You want me when I want you. Do you understand? Now, what's the deal?
Rick, come on, relax now. She doesn't understand any of this. You know that.
Hey, wait a minute, Flair. I don't tell you how to conduct your love life. You don't tell me how to conduct mine. I'm Ravishing Rick Rude. You know about my reputation, and obviously you didn't tell Fifi. Fifi, you want me, and you know it. Why didn't you call me back?
Rick, look, Fifi is the best kept secret in the world today. To a man that admires beautiful women, hey, we got a lot in common. We like the same things. She doesn't understand all this hard talk.
She understands.
New.
She understands, and she wants me. But why isn't she making the move?
Hey, look, it's very simple. I don't see her turning cartwheels or jumping up and down. She obviously doesn't want you that bad.
Well, hey, that's not your decision, Flair. I think Fifi's the one who needs to make that decision.
Well, Rick.
How about that, sweetheart? There's more where that came from. You coming with me now?
Oh, Fifi. Hey, Rick. I guess you got your answer. Sorry. Hey, next week. You okay, baby? You gotta understand things like that happen. Next week. We go again. I'll flip for you. Okay, honey, huh? You all right? Next week, we go again. God.
I know what your deal is. You're a gold digger. Well, when Mr. 10-time champion comes to, you let him know that next time you're going with me too, woman, and you're going to learn to love it.
Thank you. One, two, count two.
I used to love to catch flies. And when I caught them, I didn't like to kill them right away. What I did was I'd tear the legs off of them and I'd let them fly around till they couldn't fly anymore. Then when they dropped to the ground, I'd rip a wing off and I'd watch them quiver and hurt and pain. And then I'd whip another wing off and I'd just watch them quiver. And then I watched. And when I got sick of watching them, I squashed them. The end might not come real quick, but the end is gonna come.
He sent me ravishing.
Asked to cut the music, and now we're going to take, we've seen this before, the...
Ladies and gentlemen, Ravishing Rick Rude would like me to tell you Southern bred sweat hogs that you're not worth wasting his time.
We'll be right back.
Tony Schiavone, that is the second best feeling in the world, to get in that ring and excel at what I do. You see, this is all I know. Professional wrestling is my life. Now, there's a lot of people out here confused. They don't know whether to cheer me or slit my throat. But my entire life has been that way, involved in controversy. And speaking of controversy, Tony, I'm so thankful to be back. And I'm even more thankful that this man right here is back. My best friend in the world, Ric Flair.
Take a look at this. The Nature Boy in.
Let me just say to you, Double A, tonight, my friend, you are out of control. You are awesome. You are the Double A that we've all learned to love and appreciate. Let's set the record straight. I have been so excited about my return that I've actually been rude. Tony, some things in life never change, buddy. This is the way it ought to be. Woo!
Yeah, well, don't let me stop you guys. We'll have more worldwide right after this.
Thank you. Bruce.